Hi folks, well I have at last managed to get an overdrive unit for the Series 3 Land Rover. When it picked it up last Friday, it was all in bits, having been dismantled following a problem. One or two crunchy noises I suspect. But I haven't found anything too nasty. I spent the day cleaning all the parts and it's very usable. I'm going to replace as many of the bearings as I can, as many as need doing. All the oil seals and obviously these damaged thrust washers. But it's all cleaned up very well. This is actually a Superwinch overdrive and I believe it's exactly the same as a ferry unit, just a later example by a different name. On this website, teambrakehorsepower.com, you can find this explanation of what it does. An overdrive unit kind of steps up the output of the gearbox. It gives you, I think it's about an extra 20%. So you would use the overdrive. You can actually use it in any gear, so you know, give you 16 forward speeds to reverse, but you're not supposed to do that because these are a little bit fragile, these units. That is the spline that's taking the drive. So use it in third and fourth, and you can use it between, or you can use it with third gear rather, and it gives you like a step between third and fourth, which is really useful going up steep hills, which Land Rovers are not known for being good at. It also gives you a bit more up the top end. So for example, with the standard transmission at 16.5 miles an hour, the engine will be doing 1000 RPM in top gear. At that same engine speed in top gear with the overdrive engaged, you'd be doing 21.1 miles an hour. So it's quite a reasonable sort of step up, and it will make it more usable on long journeys. So basically all I'm doing is replacing the bearings, but the most important bit I'm hoping to cover in the film is fitting the unit to the vehicle. Mine's never had one fitted, so I'll be following the instructions in the handbook and hopefully show you in detail how I go about it. Also managed to get time today to clean up the bracket and lever which operates the overdrive. And just gave it a coat of paint as well, so it's hanging up to dry. So what remains really for today is just to show you what the various parts are. So that is the main shaft, which engages with this clutch collar which goes on the back of the gearbox main shaft. This is the input shaft with a whopping great ball bearing on it. The output shaft, and there is an oil seal that goes in there, but I'll give you a bit of detail on that next time as to the position that needs to be set. Output shaft bearing, and then you've got the lay shaft. This here is the synchro hub and the selector fork. So all that really remains is to tot up what parts I need. So I'll measure up all these bearings and get onto a supplier and the seals as well, and see what we can get. So the next video will be starting to assemble the unit, installing new bearings, and then after that I'm hoping to show you how I'll go about fitting it to the vehicle itself and then testing. So I hope you enjoyed the video and I'll update you again very soon. Cheers for now.